If you find yourself exporting your files with the same export settings over and over, then you may want to create an export preset. I'll go ahead and click Export, and I'll go ahead and create some settings for this specific photo. I'll just leave it as the file name. My file settings are great, JPEG at 100% and sRGB. I'm going to be exporting these to share on my website, so I want the quality to look really good. For image sizing, I'm going to change the long edge to 2,000 pixels wide. And because it's for web viewing, I'll leave that resolution set to 72. I'll set it to sharpen for screen. I'll keep all metadata in that photo and with no watermark. One thing I didn't do is choose an export location, so I'll go ahead and choose that. This is going to be a preset, so I'm going to select Choose a Folder Later. If I wanted to, I could export these to a specific folder. Maybe I want to export these into a folder for photos that I share on my blog, but these are some pretty general settings for me, so I may want to put them into different folders. So I'll select that option. Now on the left, this is where my presets are stored. I'll click Add on the bottom, and I'll just give it a general name. I'll call it Web Export, and I'm going to put it into the User Presets folder. But if I wanted to, I could also create a new folder if I'm going to have a lot of different export presets and I want to categorize them differently. I'll go ahead and click Create, and that preset is there on the left. Now if I click Export, a window is popping up and it's asking me where do I want to export these photos. I just have my desktop selected here, so I'll click Open. That photo is exported, and here it is sitting on my desktop. Now if I were to go into another image, I can go to Export and then set that preset on the left so I can export with those same settings.